Hello friends, here in this video we will see a problem on calculation of slenderness ratio for a rectangular section column. Here we have a question. A steel bar of rectangular section, I'll write this in the data, here the section is rectangular. (40 mm × 50 mm), so that will be the area for us, 40 mm × 50 mm. Next, it is pinned at each end, then it is subjected to axial compression. Next, the bar is 2 meter long, so length of the bar is given as 2 meter, which is 2000 mm. Determine the buckling load and the corresponding axial stress using Euler's formula. So here we have to find the buckling load by Euler's formula, so that would be called as Euler's buckling load, and the corresponding axial stress, so we have to find out the value of stress. Also calculate slenderness ratio. Slenderness ratio, I'll denote it by lambda. If the proportional limit of the material is 200 Newton per mm square, that is the compressive stress which is given. Take Young's modulus, the value is given, this will be for steel, 2 × 10⁵ Newton per mm square. So now with the data available and we have understood what are the unknowns here, let us try to get the solution to this problem. Now, the first thing they have mentioned is that it is a rectangular section, 40 mm × 50 mm. So I'll draw the section here. Now, this rectangle will have width equal to 40 and depth will be 50. So this will be the width of the column, which is 40 mm, and here we have the depth of the column, which is 50 mm. These are x and y axis respectively, and here I'll draw the section. Now this is the rectangular section of the column, 40 mm × 50 mm. Next, it was given that it is subjected to axial compression and the column was pinned at each end. See, pinned means, pinned, it is another word for hinged. So here we have the column which is hinged at both the ends. So I'll draw the diagram to explain it. So here is the column which is hinged at both the ends. This diagram indicates the column is hinged, and this will be the total length of the column. Now, when load is acting over this column and it is a compressive load from both the sides, so under the action of this compressive load, this column will bend, and it will start bending from the hinged end, and it would be completed up to the hinge end. It means the total length is taking part in the bending, so this length would be called as the effective length of the column. So now the first thing which I'll write here is, since both the ends of the column are pinned or hinged, so therefore effective length L suffix E will be equal to the length of column. So here we have effective length is equal to the total length and the column length is 2000 mm. So this is the effective length. Now after getting this effective length, I'll see the first question. The first thing which we have to calculate here is the Euler's crippling load, or we can say Euler's buckling load. So now, since Euler's crippling, or we can say buckling load, is given by, now the formula I'll write it onto the next page, it is given by P suffix E, Euler's load, it's equal to pi square E I minimum upon effective length whole square. So I'll keep this as first equation. Now, effective length value we have, capital E is given in the problem. The only unknown here is I minimum, that is the minimum moment of inertia. So for that, we will calculate the moment of inertia about x axis and then about y axis, and then we are going to compare which value is minimum that we are going to select. So here I'll say that therefore MI, that is moment of inertia for given rectangular section about x axis is given by, that would be IXX is equal to, we know the formula of a rectangle, moment of inertia about x axis, that is BD cube by 12. Here B is 40, D is 50, so 40 into 50 cube divided by 12, therefore IXX value will be, it is 416.67 into 10 raised to 3 mm raised to 4. In a similar manner we will calculate about Y-axis. So therefore MI for given rectangular section about y-axis is given by, IYY is dB cube by 12, moment of inertia for a rectangle about y-axis, so it is 50 into 40 cube divided by 12, so IYY comes out to be 266.67 into 10 raised to 3 mm raised to 4. Now after getting the IXX and IYY values, so now after getting IXX and IYY, here I'll compare, that is IXX value was 416.67 into 10 raised to 3, IYY 266.67, so IYY is less. So I'll say that therefore IYY is less than IXX, so hence I minimum is equal to IYY, and the value is 266.67 into 10 raised to 3 mm raised to 4. So this value we are going to put in the Euler's formula. I'll say that therefore put all values in equation number 1. So we have Euler's load is equal to pi square into, here it is pi square EI minimum upon effective length square. The value of E is given as 2 into 10 raised to 5 into I minimum, which is 266.67 into 10 raised to 3 divided by effective length square. So effective length we have found out, it was 2000. So therefore it is 2000 square. Hence the Euler's load, it comes out to be 131.60 into 10 raised to 3 Newton, or it is 131.60 kilonewton. So this will be our first answer. That is, we have found out what is Euler's crippling load. Now, the next question was to get the stress value. That is, how much is the corresponding axial stress because of the load. Now we have found out the load value. Because of this load, how much will be the stress which is induced in the column? So I'll say that therefore axial stress induced in the column because of Euler's crippling load that will be stress, I'll denote it as sigma, and it is equal to Euler's load upon the cross section area. Euler's load is 131.60 into 10 raised to 3 Newton divided by the cross section area is 40 into 50, because 40 is the width and 50 is the depth. So from here we'll get the value of stress. It comes out to be 65.79 Newton per mm square. This is the second answer. Now after getting the stress, the next thing is we have to find the slenderness ratio, which is denoted as lambda. So here I'll again use the formula that since Euler's load is given by, again I'm using the Euler's load formula, and that is P suffix E is equal to pi square E I minimum upon effective length square. Now after writing this formula, here I can write it in another way. I minimum, the minimum moment of inertia, it can be written as A square into K square divided by effective length square. Now how I have written this, here I'll explain it, that since K, it is called as radius of gyration, and that radius of gyration K is equal to root of I upon A, that is the moment of inertia divided by cross section area. So now here I want I, so I'll keep I on one side. This would become, when I remove the root sign here, so that would be K square, it would be K square into A square. So here I'll write it down as K square into A square. So that is, it would be here, since this is the root sign, so first of all when it goes onto the other side, that is, that would be K square, and this A will remain as it is, so it is K square into A. So here I'll write down that it is A into K square. I is A K square, because here I have explained this, that since the minimum moment of inertia will be equal to A K square, and your K is also called as minimum radius of gyration. So instead of I minimum, I can write down A K square. Now after this, the Euler's load can, since it is a load and we know that stress is equal to load upon area, so therefore load is equal to stress into area. So here I'll write down, instead of load, stress into area, and here this stress will be the limiting stress given in the problem. That is, if the proportional limit of the material is, this is the stress which is sigma c, the compressive stress given in the problem. So I'll use this compressive stress into area, which is the Euler's load, and that is equal to pi square e a, and this k square I'll send it into the denominator, so that becomes le upon k whole square. I'm sending this k square into the denominator of effective length. So here if I see, from both the sides area and area will get cancelled out, and here I'm left with pi square e upon, now effective length upon k, that is nothing but the slenderness ratio, which is denoted by lambda. I'll write down, since slenderness ratio lambda is equal to effective length upon k. So now here we have, I'll shift lambda square on one side, so lambda square goes on one side, is equal to pi square e, and this sigma c will be shifted in the denominator. So after this, since we want this lambda, I'll keep it on one side and bring the root sign onto the other side. So removing the square here, we would have root onto the other side. So root of pi square e upon sigma c. From this we are going to get the slenderness ratio. So putting the values here, therefore lambda is equal to root of pi square into capital E is 2 into 10 raised to 5 divided by sigma c is given as 200. So here I'll get the answer as 99.35. So this is the third answer. So here we have completed this problem. If we see in this question, there were three things asked. First was Euler's load. And that Euler's load we had calculated, it was 131.60 kilonewton. So this was the first answer. Next, the second question was to calculate the axial stress, that we have found out 65.79 newton per mm square, and the last thing was slenderness ratio, whose value is 99.35. And after finding all three unknowns, we can say that the problem has been completed.